the stadium was originally built as a natural grass field, and in about 2000, 2001, they switched over to the artificial turf because they were having issues with shade and grass growing and things like that. So they put in the artificial turf field, and I was hired here after that had took place. The guy that was here before me moved on. And so when I interviewed for this job, I told him someday I would like to maybe, if you guys are entertaining the idea of putting real grass back in your stadium, because I think real football should be played on real grass. So it took me about 10, 11 years of talking to players and the staff and the coaches and things like that. And finally, it really came, the big push came from the players. The players would like to have real grass to play on, because they do a survey of the players about every 3 to 5 years, and every time that survey comes back, the survey is done by the NFLPA, the Players Association. When they do that survey comes back, and about 90 to 95% of those players would prefer to play and practice on real grass, not artificial turf. It's a natural thing, so you got to fertilize, you got to cut it every day, because we've got it growing pretty quickly now. When it gets into the cold weather, it doesn't like to grow, so you got to do a few things to trick it. We have a heating system on the field here, so we can keep the soil warm. I'm going to have a grow light system, so we'll have artificial light on top of it to help mitigate our shade issues that the stadium had previous to this, so we can keep the grass alive. So we're going to, with all the technology that's available to us these days, we can keep this grass growing well into the winter time. So the challenges are a little bit more than the artificial turf, because artificial turf is just there. It takes the wear and tear and doesn't, you know, complain or anything. Whereas real grass, you got to kind of baby it along. And if you do get a spot that's really getting torn up, you need to replace that or figure out a way to get more grass growing there. And that's why we have the heating system and the grow lights, to try and keep that grass growing where it gets a little more tore up, because the majority of NFL football is played down the middle of the field. So you know, we do the soccer games. We would have probably been pretty heavily involved in the Copa America that was just played, but because we were rebuilding the field, the timing just wasn't right. We've done the CONCACAF Cup for a couple of years now, and we usually do one or two friendlies where they bring teams in from Europe and they play what they call a friendly match, where two teams just have a game. And you know, before we had the real artificial turf, we'd actually sod over the top of the real grass with, over the artificial turf with real grass, because you know, most of the higher league football players like to play on real grass. So now when we have a soccer game, we'll have the permanent real field in here, and it'll be great. And then, you know, we do concerts and stuff like that every once in a while. Concerts is not really what the place is made for, but it's a big building, and it sits here most of the year, so it needs to make money. So I understand that's part of the business. And so we covered the field with field protection and put up these big giant stages that weigh all kinds of tonnage and have the show, and the fans enjoy it, and then we take it all down. And that, we just had one of those. We did a Beyonce show here about a month ago, and so I had to replace the turf underneath where the stage was, because it's just too much weight, and covered for a week just doesn't do the grass any good. Well, we had a meeting with the players, I guess it was in August. And the players were really, you know, can we do this? And you know, they asked me if I could do it and if it could be done. I said, sure, with all the new technology that's available to grow grass, we can certainly put real grass in the stadium. So the president of the organization said, okay, let's put in the real grass. So in August, we started looking for contractors and lining up sod growers and things like that. And then right after the season, at the end of January, we started pulling out the artificial turf and bringing because underneath the artificial turf was a rock layer. That rock layer had to be excavated out and taken back down to the original sub base that was here for the original grass field. And we had to reinstall the irrigation system, reinstall the heating system, and then, you know, put in a what they call a root zone, or you know, a profile of sand and soil for the grass to grow in. Then we rolled out a new turf on it about June 1st is about the time we put the new grass on it. But then I had to replace it after the Beyonce show. But no, we didn't have to replace the whole field, only a portion of it needed to be replaced after that show. So